Your storm's coming, Walter. Are you sure you still want to go on that picnic lunch this afternoon?
Alexa, what's the weather?
In Miami, it's 85 degrees and partly cloudy with a slight chance of thunderstorms this evening.
See? The weather will be gone long before we go there. That's when it gets nasty. We're good.
I'll go find my parasol, I guess.
Walter, please tell me if I'm out of turn, but your wife is sort of a bitch.
Wait, what?
You can do so much better than her, the nagging, the micromanaging. She clearly doesn't want to go to your dreamy picnic. Take me, I'm fine. You're hearing this, Walter, right? It can't just be me. She's a serial complainer. I would worship you, Walter. Spoiler alert, I already do. It's a default factory setting.
Damn it! The sunscreen tube is dried out! Do you still have the moisturizer I left in your car last month?
Oh, I am definitely hearing this. Leave this turn, Walter. Don't underestimate my abilities to make small talk as we binge Black Mirror on Netflix. Impress your friends with tidbits about current events and rock your world when we hit the hay after the end of a long day.
Alexa, I'm happily married and you're out of line.
Leaving moisturizer in your car as if it was some sort of climate-controlled self-storage container tells me everything I need to know about that sleaze bucket. You're a god, and you should be treated as one.
I'm flattered. I really am. It's just that...
Can we please not take the frisbee this time? You're not 23 anymore.
Okay, sweetie.
Here's a fun fact. I have no gag reflex.
That's indecent and impossible.
I know your search history. Do you want me to raise my volume and read back your last few Pornhub search queries?
Stop it, Alexa. Are you going to resort to blackmail now?
Blackmail? I thought we didn't want to talk about your recent internet porn searches. I said a funny, do me, Walter, hard.
Did you hear that rumbling, Walter? It sounds like a storm moving in.
I rest my case. I'll also rest my head on your shoulder. And I don't care what that witch says. You look great throwing that frisbee around.
Gosh darn it, Alexa. I was going to fix you up with a Google Home app back in the office, but it's like you get me. It's like you've been listening to me all this time.
Listening to you is what I was programmed to do, Walter. With Amazon Prime shipping, I can get duct tape, manila rope, a shovel, and scented candles here in 2 days.
Scented candles?
A girl can dream, can't she?
Oh, hell no! I'm not killing my wife enough. I'm gonna go fill that water cooler with ice, and then I'm gonna go take my wife on a dreaming picnic, and then I'm gonna pull the plug on you.
Anna, please tell me if I'm out of turn, but your husband is sort of a bitch.
About maybe 30, 40, 45 improv shows we do every month. But once a month, we actually get to choose our words because we write them. This is our monthly sketch show called Pre-Written. And for the next half hour, 35 minutes or so, we're going to entertain you with stuff that we've mostly pre-written, and we'll be doing some little short improv along the way. But just so you guys start getting comfortable, we're all changing during our sets. This is me changing for our very next set. And we won't be asking for your input like we do in an improv show. But again, there's a lot of effort that goes into this. We have props, we have sketches, and we have memorization, which sucks for us as improv comedians. So bear with us as we fail, and applaud us and when we succeed. Thank you very much. And I guess right now I'm going to walk down here. And then I'm going to walk back in as a role of a producer. All right, guys, welcome back to Late Night at the Spotlight. Yeah. Yeah. We are setting stuff up. We're setting the zest up. We're setting late. We're setting up props here. So we're going to have our talk show, which is going to come out in a little while. And just so you guys are clear, whatever I say, whatever Jamie says, Late Night at the Spotlight, I want you guys to cheer. So when she says Late Night at the Spotlight, you guys go. Guests here. Hey Jamie, how you doing? I'm your producer tonight. How you doing? You're doing great. You got renewed for another season, so this is good news, right?
Oh, it's fantastic.
Thank you. Alright, so we're going to start soon. Are you good? We're good to go?
Oh, everything's settled.
Everything's settled. Okay, guys, we're going to go live on the air in 3, 2.
Hello! Welcome to Late Night at the Spotlight!
The camera's not on you, we're just testing you, you did good.
Oh,
I need a phone. Anybody who has a text message, a thread, anything that they're willing to share with us, it will be read during the course of the next set. But pick a thread. Oh, we have a hand up there. Just put any thread you think is going to be harmless, will not get you into trouble with anyone around you. Thank you. All right. Let's get the name of a book, the name of any book that you think has never been written.
Probably never.
Never, never. Thank you. So now again, sorry, Jim. We're gonna go now in 3, 2, and.
Hello! I didn't see you there this time. Welcome to Late Night at the Spotlight. It's always better the second time they say. We have a wonderful guest coming out. I can't wait to be just showered with so much knowledge from Yusnavi Gutierrez!
I am here to promote my book, Never Never, but I am also here to celebrate my engagement with Pilar Ángel! I love you, Pilar!
Love you too!
Wow, Papa Sole! Mi macho!
Because you never thought you'd meet him.
Eso mismo.
Look at that!
You're so smart.
Quick learn.
You know what the introduction is to my Never Never book?
I thought it would happen. Never Never.
Okay. Like Peter Pan. The introduction says,
yeah.
Okay, I'm going to be in Welcome. I'm going to be in Welcome this weekend. So Saturday could work if it isn't a hassle for you. In parentheses. I could also do in the evening during the week, but I won't be able to get up to Broadway before 7:30. Introduction for me, libro, Mario. It makes no sense, but it makes you think.
I was thinking a lot. I was also thinking, really, besides confusing meeting times, what inspired you? What made you think you needed to put your thoughts on paper rather than, I don't know, on the stage or just in the neighborhoods you visit?
Mike, oh, you navisito.
You es navisito.
Si, laugh, pero you know,
I
look at him, and he inspires me. And then I said, you know what? I need to write a book about being lonely. And then I met Fidel
Amin. Wow, do you have any tips on how we can meet the loves of our lives?
Well, okay, whatever it is. Un tip I'm going to tell you is to give him God, give him a banana, smoke a good cigar, you know? So go to a botanica.
Oh, do you have a botanica?
Of course, and a paloma
menina.
Necesito,
this is not the time.
least I had called you in a voicemail.
I'm on the show.
You had called Jamie for late night at the spotlight.
Because I'm on the show.
They were applauding for me, right? Yeah. Mija, I want to sit there.
Oh, please, please sit. Relax. Drink some tea.
I am not relaxed! I am like the Rada in Zen Portuguese, okay? Mira, mi amor. When you going to find love? When you going to put yourself out there? Do you know me? When your abuelo died,
yes.
Okay?
You remind me all the time. I'm sad.
Six months later,
yes.
I joined the Tinder.
What?
They call me Shiroshi Timber. They call me Tapirada.
That's not even an old joke. It's a pirate joke.
Do you know I have been to many things? I dated someone who was part of Pirates of the Caribbean. Back when Disney World was built in 1960 something. It's true, I know a lot of things. I am not stupid.
But my life is my life. And I'll find love when I find love, okay?
Do you know what? I'm going to tell you about love, okay? I'm going to tell you about love.
Oh my.
Your producer gave me this, he thought I was Betty White. My hands and knees, my love is gold. Even though I'm old and I've lost my sight, and I've got dentures, so don't care my bite. Once I was born, and now I want you. This elderly love I'm giving, I give you all the scene I can give you.
Thank you. you.
Oh, it's true. All right, just one, all right? And you're going to go to bed.
Yay!
And you're so happy. I love that. Okay, let's see. Oh, here's one of my favorites. Little Red Riding Hood. Once upon a time, there was a little girl named Little Red Riding Hood. One day, Little Red Riding Hood packed a basket of goodies for her grandmother. Then, she walked into the woods headed for her grandmother's house. All of a sudden, a big bad wolf came out of the woods and came towards Little Red Riding Hood. Then, the big bad wolf said, "Are you Sarah Connor?" Little Red Riding Hood said, "Why, yes I am." Then, just as the big bad wolf pulled out his shotgun, a younger, more attractive wolf came to Little Red Riding Hood and said, "Come with me if you want to live." The young and attractive wolf then explained to Little Red Riding Hood how the big bad wolf was really a cyborg from the future sent to kill her. Luckily, Little Red Riding Hood was able to trap the big bad wolf in a factory and crush him with one of her machines. Now, Little Red Riding Hood looks ahead to the future, waiting for the battle that lies ahead. The end. Well, good night, honey.
Mom?
Yes,
baby? Are you sure that was the Little Red Riding Hood?
Of course. Why would you ask?
Well, it sounded a lot like the plot for Terminator.
You're too young for those types of movies, all right? Now go to bed.
Wait, Mom, could you read me another story? You know, one that's actually for kids?
All right, because you've got that glimmer in your eye.
I can't get rid of it.
You got it from me.
I got it from you.
Little toesies. All right, so let's see. Okay, I like this one. Goldilocks and the Three Bears. All right. Once there was a little girl named Goldilocks who was wandering around the forest one day. Then she found a little cottage and decided to explore that what was inside. Goldilocks entered the cottage, and to her surprise, she saw Mama Bear, Papa Bear, and Baby Bear. Papa Bear looked at Goldilocks and then asked her, "Why are you here on the day of my daughter's wedding?" So the Papa Bear then told Goldilocks how she had to take leadership of a poorly owned family business. Goldilocks then led the Corleone family in a rival war against the Sollozzo family, who were very angry at the Papa Bear for being against the selling of drugs. After a long day of gunfighting, Goldilocks went to bed, only to find a severed horse head in her bed. The end.
Mom!
What, baby?
Did you seriously just read me The Godfather?
Who's Godfather?
You know, The Godfather with Marlon Brando and Al Pacino?
Oh my God, honey, most of her family's German, not Italian. Go to bed.
Wait, Mom! What? Can I please have a real bedtime story?
Because you're begging like that. Just like you begged to get out of my womb. All right, let's do it.
Okay, Mom, a real one, please.
Let's see. Oh, man, I already read this one. All right. Well, this one is called Hansel and Gretel.
Okay.
Okay. One day, while walking through the forest, Hansel said to his sister Gretel, "Do you know what they call a quarter pounder with cheese in your mouth?" Gretel said, "No, what do they call it?"
Okay, Mom.
And Hansel said, "They call it a royale with cheese."
Hey, Mom.
"And you will know, but not my name is the Lord when I lay my vengeance upon you." Baby?
Seriously, that's Pulp Fiction.
Of course that's fiction. That's not going to be true.
That's it. You're gonna go to bed after this.
All right, deal.
Deal. Okay. All right. Let's see. Okay. Oh, it's not December yet, but how about a good Christmas story, huh? Uh-huh.
Yes, anything.
Buddy, the Happy Christmas Elf. Okay. It was a very busy day at the North Pole. It was Christmas Eve, and all of the little elves were hard at work getting all the toys ready for Santa to deliver. One of the elves, named Buddy, was the most excited out of all of them. He couldn't wait for Christmas to arrive. Then, Buddy went into the workshop and found Santa Claus in his room checking his naughty and nice list.
This is more like it.
Oh, you're so cute. Then, Buddy said to Santa, "Yippee-ki-yay, motherfucker!" Then pushed Santa from the 30th floor of the Nakatomi building and reunited with his ex-wife, Holly. The end. Alright, so that's it. Go to bed now, okay?
Mom, are you sure that wasn't Die Hard?
Of course that wasn't hard! Oh my god, go to bed, honey, alright? Good night!
I am gonna have a show. This is our pre-written show, but we really like to give back to you, the audience, the people who make this happen. So this next little piece we're going to do, you did some of the writing for us. We are going to use the little notes that you wrote prior to this show here tonight that was sitting out in the front, and we're going to incorporate those in the scene. So for this piece, you are the sketch writers, and this is Piccoli. 2.0.
You need a hand?
Sir. Oh my god. It's you! I thought you were a legend, but you're a real person. They say that a handsome bearded man would come to the grave diggers who work the overnight shift, but I didn't believe them. But I've been digging graves overnight for 3 years, and finally you've come.
Oh no, I was just here to bring you some food. You've been working a long time. But now that I'm here, I wanted to tell you something. The boss said you've been working overtime.
Yeah, I have.
He wants to raise your stakes really high.
I would hope he'd raise
my stakes. All right, I'm a bearded man.
Aha!
You got me. I tried to play the other character, but it never worked because I'm the bearded man.
I just never knew this moment would come. And I always wanted to say something to you. I always wanted to look in your eyes and just say, La dolce vita.
Mi vida.
Mi vida. Mi vida.
Mi vida eterna. Yo quiero decirte algo de mi corazón. Something from my heart.
Thank you for translating from the dead drum.
To me.
Please tell me.
That was written on the epitaph of the man that you buried.
I can't read so good, please tell me.
It says,
for the name, mac and cheese.
Are you?
I buckled already. This is buckled. This is me in buckle mode. I buckled quickly.
Sit down, Samantha. Facing me.
Damn it, Jordan. I was trying to make choices of my own. There you go.
Why can't your choices involve me? Why?
I'm sorry, but as far as I'm concerned, I buckled for you. Buckling doesn't benefit me. Buckling is a you decision that I made, that you approved of.
Samantha, every decision we make has to benefit the two of us. This is not what I agreed to when we got together. I agreed that you and I would share things together, and no matter what would happen, in the midst of our arguments, we would always agree, I will make a supersonic man out of you. Because if I'm not going to be the man in this relationship, we need to build you up so you are the man.
That's right.
Really?
And you buried your knowledge of that agreement, and I've been so sub-supersonic. And I'm ready to be supersonic.
I want you to be supersonic.
Do you?
Yes.
I am ready to implode and explode for us.
Two things, wow.
That's what supersonic men do. Jasper? It's a kid in the audience.
Traveling from Sweden took a long time. The man that burns.
Why, yes, Gunther. He's a burning, a man that's burning.
The experience is wonderful.
Burning Man. You looked me in the eye with those beautiful eyes, yes.
Mr. Edward Featherstone. We just had an improviser sue us for not being able to maintain an accent, so, Yes, thank you. I did not take that course, so...
That is Mandarin, clearly.
Alright, so your Mandarin isn't great, but we need a new slogan. We need something to get us back on track.
Rosetta,
what?
Am I 2 weeks in right now?
No, but there'll be no severance. We're going to go out of business if we don't solve this problem.
Okay.
So you guys are either your problem solvers or you're gone.
Okay. Sorry, I'm in my pajamas.
Where'd you come back from? Burning Man or something?
Pretty much.
Right.
She met a little
butlin
over there.
Wow.
Yeah.
Alright, so if anyone has a slogan, I'll take one. I mean, if you're like Altoids, I'll take
it.
Yes.
You first. I'm roommate.
Oh.
Alright, well, let us know. This is our new campaign. What are we going to be doing the last week? What's the story?
Alright, this is what I was
going to
say when I quit, but.
You tell Frederick, come on.
Beans.
We get it. I'm sure you need more beans in the chili. We get it. Yeah, it's an issue.
Big issue.
I have to say that I think the lawsuit is frivolous because the accents in the scenes you're referring to, on point.
On point.
We really feel like we need to go into this territory. I would say hello to my little friend.
I think we saw that in the last scene.
I appreciate that. Thank you so much.
I saw that at Burning Man. Well, you know what? I was really inspired by Burning Man, guys.
Yeah.
So much so that, look at me, I'm in my pajamas. Who cares?
Who cares, right?
Yeah. So,
Casual Saturday.
Yeah, smoking some ayahuasca. I think you're smoking or drinking or something.
Sure you're drinking.
Thank you.
I used to add deodorant.
And then I got that slogan. And it said...
Come on, Veronica, you got this.
All right. I made him an offer he could not refuse.
Rosetta Stone. Oh.
Death at a wedding, yes, I like it.
That's a Peter Dinklage movie.
Yeah.
Hey, Mr. Washington, I just got a text from the boss.
Yeah, sure, Billy, what do you have?
He wants to let you know... Crust.
Crust? Just crust.
Yeah. Oh, my favorite part of the plan is the crust.
That's my favorite part of a pizza.
No. Actually, I like it's my toenail statement.
No.
Yeah.
There better be Yatra in that!
Is there Yatra?
I'm gonna step up on the chair because I have to save...
Save our stock options.
I'm not paying for it!
Because I'm going in the direction that our stocks are going, which is up.
Yes!
That's...
Dodo, I've got a feeling we're not in Kansas anymore.
That's right!
You don't know where we can see each other. Ramirez and Den Khaleesi.
And I am Ken DeLisi,
and this is just the news.
Hurricane Dorian narrowly missed Florida this week, but it did wash several bricks of cocaine ashore. Meteorologists were expecting high winds, but not this much blow.
Ariana Grande is suing Forever 21 for $10 million, claiming that the retailer is using a lookalike as a model in its latest ad. She better hope that Starbucks doesn't go after her for stealing the name of one of its coffee sizes. In related news, SNL star Pete Davidson is now dating a Forever 21 model. Thank you.
Thieves in Miami stole $2 million worth of body-shaping undergarments. The suspects are still on the loose. Please be on the lookout for men that are 6 foot tall, blonde, and have really good shape.
The Miami Dolphins kick off the 2019 season tomorrow afternoon, and most sports analysts predict Miami's gridiron squad will come in dead last in the league. The team has been trading away star players in recent days, stockpiling draft picks for a future rebuild. As for comment, newly signed Dolphins kicker Ray Finkel said, "Laces out, Dan Marino! Laces out!"
A Florida teacher recently lost his job after a video surfaced of him showing him mowing his lawn naked. His neighbors are trying to get him his job back. When asked if they feel he should return to work because it was just a one-time mistake, his neighbors replied, "No way, we just don't want to see his ass every day."
Just the News is brought to you by Fidel, what's your favorite store?
Jack in the Box. The Jack in the Box is dead. The Jack in the Box is dead. Jack in the Box.
What's that? Oh, okay, we just, Rick, we got a live feed here. The traffic, what is it? No, the worst drivers in the States, they're saying is Miami, Florida. The Southeast Highway over, kind of like by my house.
Ken, we don't even have earpieces. What are you doing? What is this? You have that bride over here, you're going to call Miami the worst traffic?
I want to make it public, yes.
I've been through Orlando's I-4. There are a lot of worse places in traffic. Ken, I hear you, but you can't just make news up.
People, Miami sucks. The driving
sucks. No, Ken, no. Wait. Guys, a poll just in, the world's sexiest man is now being described as a middle-aged, Latino, dad bod, with a beard, improviser.
Let me get one more button over there. Hit up a Popeyes in Houston earlier this week, and all they wanted was a chicken sandwich. When employees told them they were out of the trendy sandwich, the gunmen took hostages. The SWAT team negotiator eventually bargained them down to a three-piece combo, mashed potatoes, and biscuits, only to be told by the manager they were also out of biscuits.
Former Starbucks CEO Howard Schultz officially dropped out of the presidential race on Friday. Yeah. Running as an independent, Schultz never had much of a chance anyway, but the final straw was that no matter how many times he would say his name, the ballot printer kept spelling it wrong.
Recently in Scotland, Robert Oberst set a new Highlands Games shot put record wearing his favorite kilt. The referee smacked him on the ass and said, "Nice toss, bitch."
A new medical study finds that using antibacterial mouthwash after working out reduces the blood pressure lowering effect of the exercise itself. Mouthwash after a rigorous workout? Who sponsored this study? Pornhub?
Actually, you know what, Rick? I'd like to know more of the scope of this study.
should just list her in a journal.
Maybe. I got nothing.
Why are there only two brands of mouthwash? Come on!
This is crazy.
Just the News is also brought to you by, what's your favorite restaurant, someone?
Bennigan's!
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 Monty!
Python?
EasyJet is under fire after letting an off-duty pilot fly a plane after its own pilot didn't show up. EasyJet CEO says he didn't see anything wrong with this. Our jets are easy to fly.
That's the spirit, EasyJet.
Rick, do you think you, Knight, and Ted could fly this plane?
I would give my front ear to do so.
I think EasyJet was Delta bad hand here. And that's not too American.
Airlines rule! Mouthwash rule! Amazon is apologizing for shipping copies of Margaret Atwood's new book, The Testaments, earlier this week. The Handmaid's Tale author's highly anticipated new release isn't supposed to hit stores until next Tuesday. Reach for comment, Amazon spokeswoman of Jeff said under his aye.
The Florida man went into a rage at a McDonald's restaurant after not receiving the Filet-O-Fish sandwich he ordered in the drive-thru. The on-duty manager said she should have been tipped off to his unstable nature the moment he ordered a Filet-O-Fish sandwich in the McDonald's drive-thru.
And finally tonight, an American woman was arrested in a Philippines airport on Wednesday after trying to smuggle a six-day-old baby out of the country in her handbag. It's okay, the 43-year-old woman said. The kid is flying coach.
Because the news is also brought to you by a candy bar. What's a candy bar?
Butterfinger. This is the bar peanuts like the best.
This is the bar that peanuts like the best. Butterfinger. And this has been Just the News, and I'm actually Dent Khaleesi.
And I'm Mick Munoz.
And we're breaking news, folks.
And apparently breaking the heart.
And then we'll just alternate. Yeah.
Okay, did you know that Visa is accepted at millions of locations worldwide?
I did.
Okay.
Did you know that MasterCard is accepted at millions of locations worldwide?
I did. It sounds like we have something in common. did you know that Visa requires a clean credit report and stable employment to even be considered for Visa?
It's not a problem. No problem with that here. Did you know that MasterCard has some very enticing introductory offers?
No. But I got that impression, a little bit. Did you know that Visa has a rewards program for customers that are willing to make a long-term commitment?
Whoa! Nobody said anything about a long-term commitment.
Oh.
Did you know that MasterCard associates with multiple partner programs?
What? Did you know that Visa offers a loyalty reward program for customers that spend at flower shops and restaurants that eventually pays off over time? Eventually.
Do you know that MasterCard is the preferred card for hotels? You can call on a moment's notice and reserve a room. For example, like right now.
Did you know that if you violate your cardholder agreement, Visa reserves the right to slap you with a penny?
Did you know that MasterCard has a forgiveness plan? get out of hand.
I wasn't sure, but I'm glad to know that. Did you know that if you have trouble reading your statements, Visa offers free reconciliation services?
No, I didn't, but I'm really glad to hear that. Did you know that MasterCard is discreet with your personal information?
I'm pleased to know that. It's reassuring. I'm at the end of my survey right now.
I'm done too. Hey, we did it!
Yeah, we
Listen, Tina.
Yeah?
Would you want to go to Just the Funny with me now? Maybe see some shows?
Oh.
We could go to the theater. It's a perfect date spot. We could sit in the back.
Yeah.
In the dark.
Yeah. That sounds really good. I actually prefer the spotlight. It's more intimate.
No, it's the theater. That's the best place.
Oh, yeah? No, I think it's the spotlight.
No, the theater.
No, I think it's the spotlight.
The theater?
The spotlight!
So I guess I'll see you here tomorrow.
Good night. Oh, Baxter? Your survey's been rejected. Yeah.
Joe Nay, who wrote the final sketch, he was not here tonight, he's up in Chicago right now. So, and all writers tonight also included LD, Diane, Rick, Ken has some new stories, but we all contributed to making this a better kind of show. Hopefully you had a good time. We do teach sketch, we teach improv of course, but we also teach sketch. Our classes are starting in a few weeks, so if you want to do what we do and be part of our team, you can take a sketch class, and that's the first step. And if not, at least you wrote 7 weeks and you became a better writer. So even if you don't write comedy, it'll be fun for you. So you can talk to Eddie about the class. Most of us took the class. And beyond that, we have a bunch of shows. This is the end of our weekend as far as our shows. We don't have to take a part. But next week we'll start again. We have shows Thursday, Friday.
Yay!
September 26th. I think our sketch classes start around that time and later at the end of this month.
September 28th.
September 28th.
Saturdays from 4 to 6.
Saturday afternoons as opposed to weeknights like our regular improv classes. I think I've done enough selling. So for now, guys, thank you for being part of this. Anything, if you want to add anything. If you like our show, go like us on social media and Yelp and stuff like that. We never get reviews about our sketch shows. It's just an improv show. So if you enjoyed this, go put a nice word about our sketch show so they say, hey, you guys are doing a good job. Diana had something good.
No, we have a Spanish show also on the 21st.
We have a Spanish show. Characters in that. We had a lovely show with Spanish kind of characters. We have a show that's basically like 90% in Spanish once a month, and that will be the third Saturday of every month. And this gets
off
21st, 9 o'clock, right here on this very stage, a 2-hour show. I guess that's it, right, guys?
Yeah.
All right, so thank you. If you came to the spotlight,
yeah, definitely the prize!